And welcome to Small Business Today Magazine Talk Show on the SBT Magazine Radio Network. Just a few more voices in the room compared to what it's usually just Barbara and I and a guest, and maybe somebody else sitting in. But today we're kind of blessed with a lot of guests who are interested in what we do and possibly working together. And it's our...
Definitely.
Our pleasure to be here. I'm Steve Levine. I'm executive publisher of Small Business Today magazine.
I'm Barbie Davisine, associate publisher, creative director, head editor, head writer and editor of Small Business. I'm doing it, whatever. It's just as long as not in the kitchen or cooking.
So you know where the kitchen is, actually.
The only reason I had one is it came with a house.
Yeah, it's got a lot of dangerous stuff in there for you. I remember what you did with the spaghetti last weekend.
I know, that was...
That was pretty horrible.
What did I do with it? I
mean, you had stuff spilling all over the place. I mean, it's just very simple. A little pasta, a little water, boiling it, soft stuff. She had... I don't know. She needed like 40 or 50 pans. It was horrible. Anyway, but that's why we usually go out to eat. Thank you very much. There you go. Boy, it was
my favorite thing to make for dinner is reservations.
That's true.
Not joking.
I thought she was kidding. You know, I stayed away from Jewish American princesses and I've captured their queen. But anyway, we are with Small Biz Today magazine, which is both a hard copy and a digital edition right here. And we celebrate our third year anniversary in April. The centerpiece of each magazine is a cover story about somebody locally who's built a successful business practice despite the odds and now serves as a role model for this and future generations of entrepreneurs. I think the number one page in the magazine to turn to, other than the one with my picture on, of course, is the takeaway notes. We ask each cover honoree for their best practices, their best words of advice for aspiring entrepreneurs and small business owners like yourself. Barbara did, of course. But I told her to do that, which is really important.
It didn't
happen like that. But Barbara came up with that because we had one cover honoree, no names mentioned, that had so much advice that...
And it didn't help that you and John kept interviewing, asking more and more questions for every comment he made. Oh, let's add some more. So I had to really figure a way to take 90, 100, jillion, thousand words and net it down.
That's one of the challenges to put it out to the magazine, use a 10,000 word interview and then trying to get it down to 2,500 words plus takeaway notes. So, Barbara does a great job of interviewing and nailing that story and making it something special. It serves as not only education, motivation, but an inspiration for all entrepreneurs. And I believe the cover story has made it an international must-read. Everybody loves reading a rags-to-riches Cinderella success story that there was every reason they shouldn't have succeeded, yet they did. And the cover stories are chosen by Publisher Advisory Board members like Sandy Lawrence, who nominates them with the criteria that I give them. And the most important thing is their generosity back to the community and the industry, or just to their fellow man, whether it's something they're branded to or it's something they do just because it's the right thing to do. When you bless others, you are blessed. And we have found every success story, because we've looked for it, but
That's the common denominator
is their generosity, their big hearts. You know, it's easy for Coca-Cola to write a $10,000 check to support an organization. ExxonMobil, they do it all the time for a not-for-profit or charity to get behind it. But for a small business owner or aspiring entrepreneur, when you give up your time, when you give up your resources, that's like a $10,000 check. So we really believe in the success and the generosity factor do go together. The rest of the content is provided by great writers, all within 600 words, whatever they write about. And we have over 40 regular writers that we only take 20 or 25 in the magazine each month. And so it's literally been hand-selected, and Barbara goes over a fine-tooth comb.
No infomercials are allowed. They strictly have to be beneficial to the reader. It can't be like, I did this, and me, and I this. It's strictly something that's not self-promotion, but strictly information that anyone in business that's trying to learn something will get knowledge from.
Nothing newsworthy. HBJ does a great job of newsy stuff. This is all educational columns, all within 600 words, because the digital subscriber has a very short attention span. So
just like you.
What were you just saying? Oh, yeah. Anyway.
Squirrel. Oh, look, shiny.
Okay. Oh, look, shiny. That's Barbara, OLS. ADD OLS. Oh, look, shiny. What? Anyway, but that's the magazine. If you want a complimentary digital subscription while they last, because we are changing it up in September or October. I've been saying this, but we're putting a finishing touch on the website. And from now on, a digital subscription will be $18 for 2 years or $1 a month to start out with. And maybe we'll up
and
it from there.
It's well worth it. And it also helps flood victims, us.
Yes, indeed. Yes, we're our own charity. We lost our house.
And
yeah, water and
5 to 6 feet of water.
We were hell and high water. We was the other way around. Anyway, but fun. we are here with running a show in tandem with the magazine, and it's all about education, motivation, inspiration, empowerment of you, the aspiring entrepreneur or small business owner. Again, digital subscriptions. You can go through the archives at sbtmagazine.net.
Or smallbusinessmagazine.com.
And they're currently, because we skipped June because of the high water.
You were in the hospital.
That's
he
a good
also
point.
Slipped and had a concussion,
so,
in the brains.
So, March, May, 36. We did in April, May, skipped June, and July. So there's 39 issues for you to archive there right now for you to look at. So anyway, that's it. We enjoy doing the radio show. We bring on people who are important to us and important for you to know, whether they're a small business owner, whether a not-for-profit, a charity, an organization. Somebody's just written a great book, has an upcoming event, a speaker, somebody with something to share with you. And then if you missed the show, there's an audio link afterwards on Small Business Day Magazine Facebook page and a few others. And then thanks to Ron Coleman, MovieWhip.com. There we go. There we go. We've got a high-definition YouTube video within 48 hours. We post on through Hootsuite on all the social media.
And Ron's great about how taking care of SEO in his business. He's not just a videographer. He's the whole package.
Indeed. We've got about 3 minutes. I want to introduce Miss Sandy Lawrence.
There's Sandy.
Sandy's one of our Publisher Advisory Board members, one of our new members, and also is a columnist. We've got about 3 minutes. Jerry's holding up his fingers. So
I taught him.
She wants to introduce Michele Scism, who's coming with a big event coming up, and we've got some questions for her, but tell us about Michele. Welcome, Sandy.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Barbara. I came to watch my client and my coach and my friend, not to speak. However, so thank you. Thank you, Steve,
yeah, okay.
And Barbara. So I, honestly, it is my honor and a blessing to be able to introduce to you one of the most special people in the world that I've ever met. She's generous, she's authentic, she's transparent, and she is an absolutely fantastic business person herself, has started multiple businesses, been an entrepreneur since she was five. Was it five when you worked in your dad's grocery store?
Mm-hmm.
So all of her life, and now she's working to help business owners who want to have more than just a business that goes away when they go away, but to be a business that has a legacy. So I give you for today's show, Michele Scism.
Michele, welcome.
Thank you, thank you. So excited to be here.
So glad
she's not invisible or
no, not transparent.
No. Either she's opaque.
She's right here.
She's opaque. Yeah, I can see her.
Okay. Oh, thank you, Barbara.
I always stop and ask them, what's that transparent mean? You see right through them? Like, okay. Well, I guess that's it. But
means there's no hidden agendas.
That's
Michele,
right.
We're so glad you're with us today.
And thanks for having me back.
Well, it's good to have you. We had you on the other place.
Yes.
But we've got you've got a big event coming up, and we've got only about 1 minute. We'll come back with questions, but...
But we're here because Steve and Small Business Today magazine... on the Small Business Magazine Radio Network,
right,
will be the media sponsors for Michele's Legacy Live event.
Yes.
What's the date
and
of that?
September 10th through 12th.
10th through 12th, and we're looking forward to that. We're going to hear more about that and how you can get involved. And, again, let's go back to sbtmagazine.net or smallbusinessmagazine.com to get a complimentary digital subscription. And also find out more on Facebook about all the things we're doing in our events, like our Lunch and Learn with Howard Partridge today. And we've got to go to break, but we'll be right back with Michele. And you're listening to Small Business Day Magazine Talk Show
on the
SBT Magazine Radio Network.
Sure, you could choose the name everyone's heard of. And yes, they'll tell you they can do everything you want. But what they won't tell you is how difficult it will be for you to hook all the pieces together and keep them working for your business. If you're looking for a great project for your IT team, to learn all about their technology and stay busy keeping things working for your sales team, then they have a great solution. If you're looking for something that will enable your sales team to sell more and will just work without hassles and your staff spending time maintaining it, then you might want to consider Sales Nexus. Normally, the CRM is the core system. Email marketing is an add-on. Access to new contacts is an add-on. Help setting things up requires a certified consultant to engage with your company separately. Help with integration requires plugins, add-ons, and programming consultants to make it all work. Same-day support is an additional charge. This means that your email marketing data is not in the same place as your CRM and sales data. Your team has to move things back and forth and clean up lists manually, and things just aren't real time. Having all these things working seamlessly, all at the fingertips of your sales team, lets you spend your time communicating with leads, prospects, new customers, past customers, and other audiences automatically. All the while, your team is alerted to take action when the time is right for each individual customer. No, it's not too good to be true. The industry's most responsive support is available to everyone at no additional cost. And Sales Nexus works directly with your team to customize the solution to your needs and integrate with other systems critical to your business. Oh, and by the way, it's going to cost less, not more.
And welcome back to Small Business Today Magazine Talk Show
on the SBT Magazine Radio Network.
I love it as a big crowd like that.
Yeah.
I love it.
Really nice. Cool. It makes it sound
and
good.
We've got a lot of guests here with us besides Michele.
Yeah, we have. Let's recap that we have Michele Scism.
Yes.
She's a business strategist, coach, and speaker who wants entrepreneurs to see that success comes from consistent action that does not have to be painful or complex. And building a business is work, but it should be fun.
Absolutely.
As well as, so as a speaker, she brings education, inspiration, laughter to entrepreneurs. And also, there's an event coming up, and let's get information about that real quick.
Yeah, the Legacy Live event is going to be here in Houston, September 10th through 12th. You can find out more about that at legacyliveevent.com. Very excited. It's for entrepreneurs who are building a business. They've seen the success. They are not sure maybe how to take it and make it bigger, right? Something that'll last beyond them. So
fantastic. Yeah. Now, we other guests in the house, we have Sandy Lawrence. Just real quick, who you are, what you do.
Sandy Lawrence from Perceptive PR. So what I do is help people break through, get noticed, and be known.
Then we got Nikki. You want to just give a shout out, say who you are, what you do.
Absolutely. Nikki Taplin with Business Solutions. I am also a business consultant, PR, and coach, and I also am a certified travel agent.
Okay.
I'm certified with the same, but that's beside the
point. And she's going to be helping Small Business Today, Barbara.
Good afternoon. My name is Pujan Patel. I am an aspiring entrepreneur building a social currency called Agape Coin, and as well as a consultant for Business Solutions. My company is called Tribe Agency.
Fantastic.
And he just walked into our lunch and learned it. He was just looking for something to eat, and there he was, and enthralled with what we do. So.
And you introduce yourself too, please.
And I'm Greg Johnson. I'm the founder of Night of Superstars, which is an Oscar-like red carpet charity event that honors children with special needs who are really reaching beyond their adversities and excelling in areas such as academics, athletics, the arts, community service, extracurricular activities, those types of things. And we honor them and show them our appreciation and noticing them for the inspiration they are to us. So.
There you go.
What's the date of that event? Dan Pastorini is going to be part of that?
Yeah, Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick, Dan Pastorini. I get those two. Lieutenant Governor like Dan
Dante. We don't.
Dan Patrick's a Lieutenant Governor.
Yeah.
He's a former radio announcer.
Right.
Yeah, but that's going to be October 17th at the Omni Houston.
Wonderful.
What do you call it? Woodway?
Yes,
October 26th in Dallas too.
Okay. Yeah, and Dante's been on our show before. He's got a food company that he started, different rubs, meat rubs and such. Dan Passerini, yeah.
His real name's Dante.
There you go.
Just ask.
That's right.
Because if we don't know something, we'll make it up. And we'll.
That's right. He's good at it.
Absolutely.
Back to Michele. Now let's talk about Michele.
Yes.
Just a little background on you. What is your story?
Oh, well, let's see. Classic entrepreneur, born into an entrepreneurial family. You know, they had children to guarantee they had employees kind of situation. Working in the family grocery store by the age of 5. We had tons of businesses. We had a grocery store, a mobile home park, RV park, record service, trucking and business. I ended up spending most of my young adult life building that trucking business. And in 2007, we sold the trucking company and the grocery store, and I retired.
And where was
it? In Louisiana.
In Louisiana.
Yeah, in Lake Charles.
Oh, Lake Charles.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
And so, you know, I thought I was going to live the life of Riley, right? As an entrepreneur, we sell our business. It looks like it's going to be fabulous. I forgot my children were still in high school, and my husband still had a business, and I found myself on the couch. And so that wasn't going to work, and I decided to take my business knowledge and go help other entrepreneurs build their businesses. So now I just absolutely love it. I get to work with my clients to build their businesses.
So what did you learn from mom and dad, your entrepreneurs? What did you learn from them that you carried forth?
Yeah, so that's a great question. And, you know, for me, it was getting to watch them be, as Sandy said earlier, just authentic, and they did everything as right as it could be done, meaning if it was fair to the other person, they were going to be fair. If it was to help the other person, they were going to help, right? I learned how to build business from that angle. It was never about making us better. It was always about what does it look like for the outside person.
I grew up in an entrepreneur family. My parents were recruited in my grandparents' business with the lure of will pay for you to go to college, but they never would do that. And I hated those stores. I'd never worked in those stores, but I was able to watch them as they handled customers. I saw their work ethic and their dedication, even if it wasn't something they wanted to do.
Yeah.
And they kept it going. Even my grandparents passed away because of family business and the community depended on them. And that showed me a lot about ethic and support of community. And I saw them not have time for each other, but volunteer for different things because it was the right thing to do.
Absolutely.
The Soapbox Derby and Board of Trade and Garden Club and Civic Projects, but they never had time for themselves.
Small business has always been the backbone of this country anyway, and when we see in these little towns, especially Lake Charles at that point, it still is a small town, but you know.
Yeah, we had, of course, the Lunch and Learn today with Howard Partridge, phenomenal products, phenomenal systems. And, of course, his focus is, you know, how can you work on your business when you're working in your business?
Right.
What did you garnish from your parents? Did you learn ways to work on your business that are working in your business?
Yeah, absolutely. So it was taught to us very early on that it was important to set up the systems in the business. So, you know, every summer as a family, we would jump in the RV and take 2 or 3 weeks and tour the country. I've been to every state in this country in an RV, except Hawaii. And so my dad, I never forget this.
Swim.
Yeah, the big swim. So, but I was about 9, 10 years old, and we're getting on the RV one day, and he's like, "You're not a real business owner if you can't leave and still be making money." And I thought, wow, if I want to go on vacation, I better figure out how to have businesses that can work without me, right?
That's a huge lesson
that I was ingrained at age 9 with. And so really it is to look at, how much time are we spending in our business instead of spending on our business. So.
Now, and my biggest problem, I had a very successful travel agency, actually a very successful printing company, and used to design logos and illustrate brochures. And every time I leave, I lose a client because why? I spoiled them too much. And I was like, I have to overachieve, but the thing is, I spoiled them. And nobody, even my late husband, he would want to work there. And they said, well, Barbara does it this way and Barbara does it that way. And he couldn't compete with my overdoing. It's very hard when you're somebody that's ultra perfectionist and just want to go give them the kitchen sink and then nobody can do it like you. It's a hard thing to do.
Better be careful.
You
have to be able to duplicate yourself, or it's not scalable.
That's right. So. And I'm a hard thing to duplicate.
Don't you think one of the challenges is that not employees don't have, obviously, your work ethic?
That's true. They also don't have your vision.
And right? your expertise.
Give them vision. So yes. Or they'd have their own business.
That's right.
It. That's exactly
so
right.
So how do you run a business for employees who don't have the work ethic?
How do you empower your employees to feel like it is their business?
Another good question.
So,
yes.
Good question. It is about the empowerment. It is about, you know, one of the things. So we sold our trucking company in 2007. Every year on Boss's Day, I get two cards in the mail from employees I had in the trucking company. Right? It's been eight years since they worked for me.
Isn't that nice?
Because it was part of a family. They were part of a family. And because of that, we empowered them to make decisions. When they made the wrong decision, we had to deal with that, right? But our people stayed for a long time, and they got really loyal into whatever industry and whatever business that was. So, yeah.
The problem was having great guests with great content. It goes so fast. And we've got to go into another break. And you're listening to Small Business Today Magazine Talk Show on the SBT Magazine Radio Network.
Hello, I'm Paul Marcus, owner of Affordable Searches, your premier investigation company specializing in comprehensive background checks nationwide. Business owners know one of the most important things to do is the hiring of employees. However, if you make mistakes or you don't check them out thoroughly, this could lead to problems. Some of the problems may be unsafe business environment, possible violence in the workplace, negligent hiring, lawsuits, and a turnover of employees. Our website has a wealth of information for you to read and learn how to run the correct background checks. We are also available for free consultations at 1-877-685-6691. Visit our testimonials page to see what our current customers say about us.
And welcome back to Small Business Day Magazine Talk Show on the SBT Magazine Radio Network. I'm sure glad the office cleared out sales next to us because we've been so loud today.
I know.
I have a microphone, but that's okay. We're having a good time. Got some great guests and guests sitting in. So that's why it all comes together. But
it's
we have been lovely, Michele Scism, who's here and promoting her big event coming up in September, which we're very proud to be media sponsors of. And we'll need to talk to her about that and how you get involved and how you attend and what the agenda is going to be.
Yeah.
But I saw you pack them in, and you have hallelujah from the back of the room last time you were in. Oh, yeah, I couldn't wait to get to the mic and tell their stories, you know?
Yeah.
Those empowerment. I said, good Lord, I hope she doesn't pick me, because I don't know what I'd say. But then again, I was in the back of the room. So anyway, we're back with Michele.
You pick me, I always
you have no problem
well,
going
well, you weren't
like
there, man. I was in by myself. Anyway, but Michelle's glad to have you back.
Let's talk. Talk about your events and how did you get involved in that?
Oh, gosh. You know, I went to an event, I guess the end of 2009, and sat in this audience. I was on second row, and the guy's on stage. It's a three-day event, and he's teaching people how to build their businesses, and I thought, I could do that. And so I went up to him at the break and said, if I hire you, will you teach me how to do what you're doing? And he said, yeah, and that was it. A year later, I did my first event, and this is my fifth year to do it. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the focus is strictly teaching people how to build their business. Is that?
Build their business. That's exactly what this is. So, you know, the story behind this, it's always been called Take Action, Get Profits. When you came last year, it was Take Action, Get Profits. And we shifted it. The content shifted a little bit this year. It's called Legacy Live. And the reason is because about a little over a year ago, on my birthday, actually, I got a phone call, and it was my mother. And she was calling to say that she found my father on the floor. And she couldn't wake him up. We got him to the hospital, and he had fallen in his yard, and he had a brain aneurysm, and he passed away the next day.
Oh, Lord.
So we, as a family, you know, we had sold businesses, but we're entrepreneurs, so we had started more businesses. So again, we have family businesses, and I have my own businesses, and everybody's got their stuff going on. And as a family, we took a month off and did what we needed to do to support each other and to support my mother. And I came away from that and went, wow. Our employees still got paid. Our clients all still got cared for. Everything worked because we create legacies. We build businesses in a way that creates a legacy. At the same time, there was a woman in Lake Charles who owned a day spa. And she passed away the week before my father. And so I was driving home. She's been having this day spa for 25 years. I have gone a gazillion times for all kind of things. And I drive by it one day, about 2 weeks after she passes away, and there's a for sale sign on the window and the chain on the door.
It hit me.
She didn't have a system. She didn't have a way to transition that to the next generation or to sell it or anything like that. And I had one of those aha moments. I went, oh my God, this is what my clients have to learn. That's the piece I do naturally. We've always built businesses like that. I didn't realize other people weren't. And so, that's what this year's event is about.
Mm-hmm. Do you have an exit strategy? That's a question.
Absolutely. It's all starting from the exit strategy.
Whether it's to your children or whether it's to turn over a partner or whether you have something
in mind. Divorce your husband.
Divorce your wife. Which I pretty much run the business by myself anyway, so you know. No, Barbara's a big part of it. So tell me about some of the things you'll be covering in the conference to achieve that goal.
Very good. So we're going to look at a lot of systems.
I just asked that before she did, that's all.
That's all. You beat her to the punch. We're going to look at where you are in your business, right? So if we don't figure out where we are, then how can we figure out where we're going?
Right.
We're
going to
figure out exit strategies. So what exactly is it that you want from this business so that we can build it in that format? And then beyond that, we're looking at the system. So we're looking at sales. We're looking at marketing. You know, all the pieces that build those businesses.
Should you always look to end first?
Absolutely. That's the big key, right?
It's
to know. And, you know, when we started the trucking company, for example, well, I should say my dad, I was 7 when he started it. But I don't think there was a real exit strategy at that point. But along the way, we went, oh, wait a minute. We should be building this in a way to have an option. And we chose the selling option, right? But what is it? Is it to transition to the next generation? Is it to bring in major investors? What is the plan you need to put in place?
Is it ISO employees, employee stock, like Sue Burnett, Burnett Staffing, and she and her husband were getting up in years, and the employees were worried. What happens if they pass away?
That's right.
And so she found out about the ISO and still ASAP. Active.
ASAP,
option program. Mm-hmm. And they restructured it. She's still running the show. Her family's still calling all the shots, but they actually, once the employees know that they become employee-owned, it's an employee-owned company, their profitability was like tripled in 1 year because they knew they owned it. They were secure with it. And
you got some great ideas, too.
It was brilliant. It was very brilliant.
It was December of 2012, I think.
Yeah, you can go on our archives, SBTMagazine.net or SmallBusinessMagazine.com.
And you can still read Sue Burnett's story.
Yeah, because it's really a fascinating thing.
I want to put Sandy on the spot a minute because
Sandy
is your client.
Yes.
But she's also your coach.
She is my coach.
Tell me what she's brought to your business.
She has brought to my business amazing profitability. I can't even say the word.
I was having a problem with that, too. Profitability, I think
profit, it's... Let me just start with profit.
Yes.
She's helped revenue. Well, I was always getting revenue.
But
I've been in business since 2002, so I've reinvented this company several times. But each time, my business was based on me and my clients. I adopted my clients. And when I lost a client, I go get a new client. I didn't have a strategy in place. I had lots of visions. Didn't have a strategy, no exit strategy for sure. And Michele has, with her coaching and mentoring more than coaching probably, and leading by example, has just helped me. My business has exploded in the last couple of years. So she's been my coach now. We're going into the third year. Yay! I just signed up for another year, so we're ready to.
That says a lot.
I am ready to rock and roll with Michele. So yes. So thank you for asking.
What makes her so special? There's lots of coaches out there.
There's lots of coaches out there.
That's a true statement.
I've had other coaches before. I firmly believe in coaching. Again, what I said originally when I was talking about her is she's very authentic. I mean, when we, in her coaching program, I'm on a one-on-one coaching, but once a quarter we come together for a 3-day mastermind intensive. And Michele just opens the books and shows us what she does. And she's very authentic if she makes a mistake and says, here's what didn't work. And that's what I want. I want somebody that's real. I'm also, as her PR person, I'm on team calls every Tuesday. So I hear her interactions with the other team members, and I've told her this before, I learn as much from that, because I'm not the person that empowers. I mean, I'm the one that wants to, like, watch over everything everybody's doing. And I see people make mistakes, and yet Michele just keeps on going. I mean, it's just, she really seriously is building a legacy, and by example, showing us how to do that.
Let's continue to love fest. What do you like about
I have a question.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay. I have a question.
I'm sorry. You look like you're interested here.
Yeah, you know, could you take your tie? I need you to tighten your tie a little tighter.
Your question, please.
Do you have an exit strategy for your own self, what you're doing right now?
Absolutely.
How have you done that?
Absolutely. So my exit strategy is to have the option, first of all, to take this exit strategy if I want it. But I am building a business that is sellable, and that is my strategy. My children are not interested. They're more artsy, so it's not going to be something that's left for the family. That's not the plan at the moment anyway, unless they showed up and changed their minds and wanted to do that. But, yeah, it's all about putting strategies in place. So we're working. You know, we have an operations manual. We have the pieces of the business that have to be put together, marketing. The other thing to look at is that it's not something that is done in the first year, right? I actually have a 7-year legacy plan. So it's going to take 7 years to build this business to the point where it's sellable. So, yeah.
Now, Steve, you can answer Steve's question. Okay. I give you permission.
Awesome.
You wanted to know about Sandy. What do you think about Sandy?
Yeah.
Let's talk about Sandy services.
Let's talk about Sandy. Oh, yeah. Sandy services as PR. Absolutely. So number one, Sandy is extremely well connected, which you want in a PR person. Okay. Number two, it doesn't matter what our contract is. So Sandy says she doesn't, adopt her clients as her children, but I think she does, because she gives me way more than I ever expect. She's constantly sending me things, going, "Oh, you should speak here, or you should do this, or you should," right? Constantly looking out for me. I'm so taken care of. Yeah. She is awesome.
She suggested we do another lunch and learn.
We were trying to do one end of August, beginning of September, but I don't know if we can get it out that fast. But we are going to have you back as a lunch and learn speaker in November. I believe that's November the 10th.
10th, I believe.
I believe. So November 10th, have you
it's
back
a Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Yeah.
For lunch and learn at the Wyndham Hotel. In case we didn't stand there.
And Pigeon wants to ask a question.
Oh, Dijon. Oh, okay.
I like to get involved.
Right,
I mean, for me.
He's already looking at it. So,
co-hosting, yes.
When I meet anybody, it's all about how are we going to co-labor together. Right? Even if you're wearing swimming shorts when I see you, right?
That's not a pretty sight.
I'm sorry.
I've seen this.
So, Michele, I got a question for you. Have you considered, I mean, you have a great concept, and I would love to see generations from now, many generations, I'm talking 10 generations or 500 years from now, for your concepts to still be consistent and relevant. Have you considered writing a world-changing book? Because I think you are definitely a world changer.
Oh, thank
with
you.
Your,
so I have written a couple of books, but the big book is what needs to come.
Is that coming?
Come.
Is that on the horizon?
It hasn't started yet, but it's percolating. So, yeah, absolutely.
Everything starts with an idea.
That's right. Everything starts with an idea.
But she does have some books already that you can get now.
What are those books called?
So one that she just published, Take the Risk or Get a Job.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I love it.
Hallelujah, I like that.
That says it all right there. That is my opinion.
That's the hard part. Yeah, because there are people who do not want you to succeed. They want you to be doing their level of mediocrity, which means having a job and doing the 9-to-5 bit or more and not having anything. And there are people who don't want you to succeed. And they'll tell you, so you can't do that. You don't have any entrepreneurial spirit. You don't know what you're doing. And some of the best success stories have come from those who were told, no, you can't.
That's right.
And you won't be able to. So it takes the skin of a rhinoceros to start a business, and it takes standing out on the edge, taking a risk, and willing to make it happen.
Absolutely.
Shut up. Okay.
Exactly. Right. Right. Yeah. If you're not willing to do the work, right, then go get the job.
Well, a good thing to say about that is there's people that follow their ideas, and there's people that don't. If you don't follow your idea, then you're going to end up working for the guy that did follow his.
Yeah, absolutely. Right? Absolutely.
Yeah, that's what we're about, is encouraging people to do that and not just
just having an idea. What's the one the guy said, the worst idea? You always have that.
I love this one. You know, a lot of times the words of advice are the same. Have a great relationship with a banker, a great relationship with an attorney, a great relationship with a financial planner. But what one of our cover runnies said was, even the worst idea executed is far better than the best idea you only think about.
That's right.
And I thought that was...
It was so well said. Yeah.
It was. In other words, just do it. You know, so many successes have come from strikeouts. How many attempts was the light bulb?
The filament,
And the filament. And just, right, as much as Babe Ruth was a home run king, so he was
struck out
king.
More than everybody, too.
He got to bat more than anybody
That's
else.
That's right.
Exactly. I'm not going to offer any of my ideals or opinions on it, but I'd like to ask how important, because I know it's very important to you, but maybe describe that importance of attitude and not just a positive attitude but a joyful attitude, not when things are going great but when things aren't going great, because right. That's your true character right there. So I'd love to hear your ideals on that.
Yeah, so I think as an entrepreneur, we go through the ups, the downs, the hills, the valleys, all of those things. And so you're right, it's all in how you act and react in those situations. Right? It's about that attitude. So, do we have those moments when we want to stomp our feet and cry and scream? Yes. Do I go out in my backyard and do that every once in a while? Yes. Right? But then I, like, suck it up, go back in, get on the phone, and get on the radio show. Right? Yeah. Whatever I have to do. And because I know it's just a piece of what's going on. And so, yeah, I think that that's huge. And it's a good question, because I know, so I heard someone say once that the loneliest place they could be was in their own head, right? And so as entrepreneurs, most of us have a tendency to work alone. We're working out of our home, or we're solopreneurs for a very long time before we build that in-house team. And so you got to be real careful, because that space in your head can get really nasty.
Right? You know, that there's the Goldman Sachs 10,000 Small Businesses, and I know that it's a really great program for people. Because when you're an entrepreneur, you're doing all your things. You can't vent with your employees.
Right.
And so it gives them an opportunity to have monthly roundtables with their cohorts from the same classes to share the same ideas of how to do this. Oh, I've got an employee does that. What are you doing? It's a great way to feed up. The advantage of working with one spouse, though, is when one's down, the other can build you up and vice versa.
Yeah.
But I know it's got to be a lot harder.
We're both down. That's when
never let that happen. Never let that happen.
No.
Nikki.
Can you say the name again of that book about risks?
Yes, Take the Risk or Get a Job.
The ironic thing about that is my post this morning before I ran out of here on Facebook was, at some time you have to take the risk. But the thing is that nothing's going to happen. Nothing is going to happen that you desire to see happen until you decide that it is worth taking the risk. Mm-hmm. It's got to be worth it. Whatever you want, it has to be that thing that says, I can't live my life another day without doing this. It's got to be worth the risk.
I give my clients a card to stick on their monitor, and it says, how bad do you want it?
That's right. That's it. Anybody, all of the entrepreneurs, the only way, you know, again, that their success is because they continually keep on keeping on, and they never give up. The only way to fail is by quitting.
And remembering that there is no success without adversity. And
that's
one
right.
of my favorite lines, I don't even know where I got it, but if there is a
victory,
there had to be a battle.
Yeah.
What kind of victory would it be if a World Series team showed up and the other one didn't, and they won by default? That's a win, but not a victory. And when you are started business, nobody says it's easy. Everybody has their own business. It is a challenging path, and things come at you didn't expect. And it's just being able to say, this is all part of the process. And, you know, our first cover story was Farouk Shami of Chi.
That's right.
And when he finally came up with a product that didn't have ammonia, that didn't make everybody sick, including himself, he called Clairol and L'Oreal and said, you won't be successful. And we're not interested, and hung up on him. And now it's interesting, he's worth $2.5 billion on a product he invented. He offered those two hair care giants.
Wow.
And $2.5 billion. And happy they didn't take it, and now they have their own commercial saying ammonia free. About free, we gotta go to break.
That's
Isn't
right.
that right?
That's
about, that time,
yeah, about that time,
that free time just went out from under us.
So anyway, we're really having a great show here, and you're listening to Small Biz
Magazine Talk Show on the SBT Magazine Radio Network.
At Affordable Searches, our mission is to provide our customers with the most thorough background check possible to protect you, your employees, and also your business. We do so by contracting with companies across the country that provide us with the best information possible and in a quick turnaround time. Our turnaround times average anywhere from 24 to 48 hours. Our pricing is very competitive, and we are always here for you. We're always here to answer any questions you have. Please give us a call at 1-877-685-6691, and we'll be glad to answer each and every question that you have.
And welcome back to Small Business Today Magazine Talk Show
on the SBT Magazine Radio Network.
Boy, that sounded good.
Isn't that good? Great.
And
sounds
we're
terrific.
Supposed to be here with just Michele Scism.
You have to have us all here every time.
I'm telling you, this is great.
Book
come on
down.
That.
Advisory board members can come on anytime. Columnists can come on anytime. Clients can come on anytime. We've got a little bit
anybody of wants to pop in, they can pop
just
in.
Just show mm-hmm. up. That's right.
That's right.
Show up and then take us to dinner. We're good. It's all part of it. Yeah, that's the only time Barbara and I ever meet is a dinner after the show.
We like choo-choo sushi.
That's a, we all usually go out for sushi. So, but anyway, we're back with Michele, and we want to talk about her event coming up in September
yep.
again.
Yes. Now, where is it going to be?
It is going to be at the DoubleTree on. Oh, help me, Sandy. Where is that?
59.
On 59 at
right
Greenway.
Next to Lakewood Church.
Yeah, oh, yeah. If you know where Lakewood Church is,
that's it by Wesleyan and Ed Lowe.
Yeah.
That one.
Yeah.
Got
it's
it.
A wonderful hotel. They remodeled it last year, and it is fabulous.
It used to be the Renaissance Hotel.
It was. It was a Renaissance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so now, well, give us a rundown about the event. What's the agenda?
Yeah, so we will be focusing the first day on determining where you are in your business and what is that exit strategy that you want and what systems do you have to get in place to get that done. And then when we move into the second day, we'll focus on sales and marketing to develop that, because we cannot build a legacy business until you have a sustainable business. So if it's not making you money, if it's not profitable, if it's not in a scalable format, then we can't build something that can be to make the difference in the world that you want to make. So we'll focus on that the second day, and then the third day we come back and wrap it all into this pretty package. So a lot of fun, a lot
minute.
Of great stuff.
Put Steve in a pretty package.
You're gonna put Steve in a pretty package.
Yeah,
okay.
Put him in. Put a little bow in his hair.
I thought I already was.
Well, you were wearing pink. Let's get a little bow.
So
that's right.
What time does it start?
Starts at 9 a.m. on each day, and we run till 5 each day. The first night we have a VIP party afterwards.
No.
So you want to stay for the party?
Okay.
And
sponsors are invited to the party.
And you
said there's something different about this year's event than previous years?
Yeah, this year's. So in previous years, well, I don't know if you guys know, but I started out actually teaching social media. So in the beginning, this was a social media event, and then it moved strictly into a marketing event, meaning we were just teaching marketing, and now we're teaching business structure, and so business format, you know. So it's a little different.
Did everybody tweeting at the event?
Oh,
and what's
yeah.
the website to sign up?
It is legacyliveevent.com, and you'll see plenty of buy buttons there. So
legacyliveevent.com.
Legacyliveevent.com.
Fantastic.
What type of professionals should come out to this event, or what professions would benefit from this event?
Good question. Very good question. So my focus is on service-based industries. So they may be accountants. They might be attorneys. They might be contractors, right? They might be coaches, but mostly service-based. I've spent most of my life in service-based industries, although I did spend quite a few years in a grocery store. But that's what we focus on is service-based.
That's customer service.
Yes, that's exactly right. Very much.
But you know what? Customer service goes across the board. I don't care what you're doing. I don't care if it's cleaning up dog poop in someone's yard.
That's
you,
right.
You've got to do customer service.
A very successful business that does that.
That's right what I'm saying. There is. I'm not joking. It is an excellent
absolutely
business to do. And but the thing, if you don't have customer service, when there's competition, it's the one that I say long after the price is forgotten, the quality of service remains. Yeah. And that applies to any business.
Even nonprofit events.
Exactly.
Even nonprofit events. That's exactly
that's it.
Right.
Yes. Oh, it's so important. When I'll do a fundraising event, I make sure that people are routed to everybody that's a sponsor. They have to go in and meet each sponsor at every table, get a card punched for them to get in a drawing, and to then get to all the other activities.
That's exactly
so
what
we do. So because you've got to pat them on the back. You've got to appreciate. You can't just put a little sign. Well, thank you for Steve Lane's. Here we go. And, you know, it's like, whoa. Ma'am, thank you, ma'am. Yeah. So you.
Category all by itself. How to excel in your customer service.
Absolutely.
You know, you talked about that dog poop lawn picker up or whatever. But I don't remember where I heard it. But there was a
crappy thing to talk about.
There was a child who started a business, a youth, that. What to clean people's wheels. You know that you wash your car, but you don't want to get in there gritty. And so they started, made money, but he started hiring other kids to do it too, and then he took a piece of it.
Yeah.
The youthpreneur.
That's right. And really great. Great.
Get a job done that people need.
That's right.
You know, sometimes about finding out what somebody wants and then help them get it.
That's all
There's
it
no
is.
No closing. When you can prove you got exactly what somebody wants, they'll move heaven and earth together. They'll pay you whatever you want to do that job. And people want an experience now. It's not just do you want to go out to eat, but they want to feel good about where they're going to eat. They
exactly
want to feel good about the service and the decor. And it all has to go together.
Well, so I believe that, you know, the way we've seen businesses evolve is the whole idea of the experience, right? Social media changed everything.
Oh, yes.
When it comes to the way we build business. It's why we'll pay $7 for that dollar cup of coffee at Starbucks.
Oh,
for
yeah
the experience, right? And I work with my clients to, we don't compete on price. We compete on value, right? Value and experience go hand in hand. So when you can show the experience, you can show the value, and when you become needed, your prices are raised. So, yeah.
Tell me about your sponsors for this event.
I do. Besides y'all, I have amazing sponsors.
Oh, wait, what's our name?
We're the only one we want to hear about.
Small Business Today Magazine.
Small Business Today Magazine
is a sponsor.
Is a huge sponsor. You need to come out just to meet them.
Oh, yes.
And, I do have amazing sponsors. Sandy Lawrence is there as my PR sponsor. I've got Jenna Rodriguez. She does branding. Paul Taubman is websites. Bellany Deshawn is relationship coaching. Karen Lynn Marr teaches people how to write their books. The list is so long, I should have wrote them all down. Sandy, am I thinking, forgetting? Robin Young's
Robin
coming
Young
in, Wealthy Women, and Joyce,
W.
O'Grady in the Accountability Squad. Joyce Brown works with people on improving their sales closes. Lots of great sponsors.
Do you need any more?
We always have room for more.
Okay, so anybody listening would like to be a sponsor can
absolutely
contact you how?
They can contact me. They can just email me, Michele with one L, at decisiveminds.com.
I think Decisive. Sales Nexus should be a sponsor, don't you, Barbara?
I think so.
Yeah.
Now,
tell me about the event name changed, huh, to Legacy.
It did. So we were Take Action, Get Profits, and decided that it was time to take it up a notch. And it really is, you know, once I wrote that book last year, Take the Risk or Get a Job. And Sandy and my other clients, they're always saying, you know, Michele kicks us in the butt with her velvet slippers. And I am, you know.
I like that. Repeat that.
They always say that I kick them in the butt with my velvet slippers. And, I am not a great coach. I am a mentor because I am going to tell you what I think you should be doing. And so, because I have an opinion.
Or not be doing.
That's exactly right. And I don't know. I don't even remember where we were going with that question. What did we start with? We got sidetracked.
We're talking about sponsors. We're talking about the name change, the legacy.
The name change, exactly, the legacy. And so, when Dad passed away, and then I had written that book, and I got really clear this year on my point of view of building business, and I'm also very clear on who I work with. And so, I am not for everyone. Not everyone wants to build their business the way I want businesses to be built, and I'm fine with that.
And who?
Not everyone is for everyone.
Yes, not everyone is for everyone. That's a good way to put that. So, you know, I'm clear on who my ideal clients are.
Who are your ideal clients?
So my ideal clients are service-based industry people. They are building a business and they have had success. So they have clients. They probably find themselves working in their business way more. They can't figure out how to get it to a point where someone else maybe can come in and take some of that off of them. And so that's actually my specialty. And that's who I like to work with. So.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. How do you get good employees and maintain them? How do you find them?
So we put people through the paces, actually. Let's say, for example, I want to hire a new assistant. Mm-hmm. And maybe one of her jobs is booking my travel. And I travel a lot. And so people have to go through processes. We have them create a video that and send it to us to watch on why they should be an employee. And then once they get past that, because that eliminates over half of the people who apply, and then because they cannot figure out how to put the video up, and we're a very technology-based business, so that eliminates you, right? Once they get past that, then they're going to get something that says, okay, great, so book Michele on, you know, she wants to go here, tell us what you would do, and then we see what that response is, or some other project, and we give them projects.
You mean book on a trip or somewhere?
Yeah, we have them send us an itinerary of what they would do, and right, we're looking for that, and then once they get beyond that, then we go into an actual
call project. Call readyfortrip.com.
That's your plug
daughter,
for them?
That's my daughter and son-in-law.
You almost have to audition them as yes. They're auditioning for a part in a play.
Yeah.
Show us how you would take this role.
Yeah. It's like intern to hired.
Yeah, yeah, that's exactly right. So that's good. Yeah. I like that, intern to hired. You better buy that before I get home.
That's right. Did you hear that? Better buy that before she gets home.
I have 400 URLs plus already. I don't drink and I don't smoke. But I collect URLs, so.
That sounds like a really bad old joke. I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't cuss. Damn it, I left my cigarettes on the bar.
All right. What would be your best words of advice be for an aspiring entrepreneur, small business owner, the people who listen to the show? If one of them was have a great relationship with a banker or a financial planner, what would be some of your best words of advice?
I think that in this day and age, to be successful as an entrepreneur, you have to have an audience paying attention to you. The problem that entrepreneurs have is that they don't have a big enough reach. And so when there are things that we can do to guarantee our reach, number one, never assume they're going to come find you. You always go find them. How do you do that? Your own radio shows like this with an audience. You guys are new to me, right? I get to meet new people. You blog, you do other radio interviews, you tweet, whatever that looks like. You create your own audience, right? And so I think a lot of entrepreneurs screw up because they think that, well, I'll just put my stuff out there and people will find it. It doesn't work like that, people. It's not a field of dreams. So, yeah.
Good line. What else would you recommend?
That's right. I'm sorry.
What else would you recommend?
So I would also like to have you look at not being overwhelmed by the full picture of what you're attempting to do. It's very important for you to take the next step. So one thing is to know what the next step is. The other thing I think everyone is screwing up with is that they're not having enough sales conversations. If you're not making enough money, if you're not bringing in enough, you know, if your cash flow is suffering, it's simply because you're not out there promoting yourself and having those sales conversations.
And so then asking, will you buy, will you
do? For the money. I know I do a lot of, do a lot of surveys, a lot of research with entrepreneurs, and that's one of the biggest issues. They don't know how to ask for the money.
That's right.
So
that's
it's a big problem.
Well, if you find the problem and you can give them a solution, there's no reason why you shouldn't ask for the money.
Absolutely. And
doctors have no problem in giving, asking you to pay their bill. You came to me with a problem. I wrote your prescription. Here you go. That'll be $50, please.
Even though they're only practicing medicine.
Yeah, good point.
The acronym form. So forming. So to forming, imagine a first date. So, you know, first what you do is talk about family. After you talk about family, then what do you talk about? Well, what do you do? Occupation. Then it's like, what do you like to do? Recreation, right? Mm-hmm. F-O-R. Well, M is the money. Well, go make a move or ask for the money. Yeah. Your choice.
Yeah, very good.
I like to
very good.
That one.
It's a real issue for entrepreneurs. It really is.
Education. Should entrepreneurs stay in and find ways to re-educate themselves?
Absolutely, because everything's changing and it changes very rapidly. So be very careful that you don't get stuck in that mindset of, well, this is the way I did it 10 years ago, and why isn't it working now? Right? It's got to be different. But, you know, Steve and I were having some conversations before the show, and that's the kind of questions are like, how can we take what you did years ago and modernize it for today? Right? And look at the current channels.
Something interesting. Do you find that things keep becoming cyclical? That so some of the young kids will say, yeah, that's that first it was old school, and then now suddenly it's going back to real basics, like no more PowerPoint, yep, going back to like...
I call it grassroots, right? And that is that you mail somebody something in the mail, all of a sudden it's unique because nobody's doing it anymore, right? You pick up the phone and call and they're like, whoa, they called me, right? People aren't doing it anymore.
Right.
So, yeah, go back. And
because I said we had one person, we had the PowerPoint. They said, no, we're going to use a big notepad or something like that, and Crayolas, or I don't know.
That's how I started, but it just didn't work for 500 people.
500 people, how do you do that? I mean, that was like, I sometimes a little...
Yeah, so
it applies to the situation at hand.
Now, you didn't talk to Howard today, but he had that little workbook.
Brilliant.
And he said, you know why I do that? He said, because if I put a PowerPoint up there on a group like this, they're all going to be texting and be looking around. But this way, they have something to take notes in small enough, and they'll be paying attention to that instead of a PowerPoint presentation.
Like the overhead projectors, guys. Remember
I hated that. I hated that. Right?
Shadow puppet?
Because you don't know what you're going to write next.
Yeah.
It takes time to write.
What was great about today was I just had all my clients in Houston 2 weeks ago, and we did 3 days on how to do sales or how to do speaking presentations, and one of those things was what to have to hand out in the room. So there I can't wait to go home and show everyone that.
I think we need to thank a couple people, Barbara, before we end the show. One is we got to thank Jerome Davis.
Engineer extraordinaire, yes.
He managed to stay awake the entire presentation.
Yay! Ronald Coleman.
Ronald Coleman does
MovieWhip.com.
And does our videos, and he's a professional, whether you need your own movie or commercials.
SEOs, tying in everything.
Amazing, exactly.
And then we have Tony Now with AutoShopper.biz.
One of our sponsors.
And also gave us cars to use after the flood when none were available.
We've been flooded with blessings, and that was the first one. Barbara's without cars. About a home, when we close on our back, and my friend Tony Noun on my board gave Barbara a car to start using that next day.
That's wonderful.
So, and then we have Craig Klein,
Sales Nexus,
which has got he's got wonderful training, CRM, definitely. What's his website? SalesNexus.com.
Exactly.
And it's NEXUS, SALES.
Paul Marcus, is he still in there?
Paul Marcus is affordable searches, and he helped us more than he'll ever know, affordablesearches.com, and finding, when I was trying to find a place to move, and there, I found an abandoned house, and he was helping me find who owned it so I could get a place to live when nobody else would take pets. So he's a...
And now we got a deal.
Such a deal.
There you go. And all those people want to thank, and we want to thank all the folks who dropped in as a sit-in on the show,
our studio audience.
And I think we've hit about everybody.
Yes.
Again, thank you. Yes, absolutely.
Thank you for all you're doing and how you're changing the world with your words.
Thank you so much, Barbara.
We believe small business is a rock-hard foundation of our economy. Small business collectively is the nation's largest employer and the nation's largest taxpayer. We are found on small business. Shopkeepers, street merchants, craftsmen, and farmers. That's how this economy was started.
That's right.
And shop small business. Saturday should be shop small business every day.
Every day, always.
Every day.
That's what we believe, and we will continue to do that.
And you picked Houston. And how come Houston? Because could it be we have over 92 consulates here? We have more startups than anywhere in the U.S., and the majority are women? Could that be?
Absolutely. And there's a lot of money here. And, I love Houston. It is my adopted city at this point. So I do live in Louisiana, but I'm in Houston a lot.
Good.
It's only 2 hours.
I'll come back.
We're the friendliest big city in the world.
All right?
Awesome.
We're good friends. And this has been a great show. A lot of
fantastic
great people here. And you've been listening to Small Business Magazine Talk Show on the SBT Magazine Radio Network.